Hi and welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, hello, I'm Jamie Lee. Today I'm going to be filming one of my favorite videos, which is a 10 by 10 capsule. I absolutely adore these because they are just a reminder that we have infinite outfit possibilities at our fingertips from what we already have in our closet. Today's video is in partnership with Everlane, which I'm so proud to partner with them on a monthly basis. So what I'm going to be doing is sharing with you some of the newer items that I've added to my wardrobe over the past few months in combination with some of the older pieces that I've owned from the brand for many years. You'll probably know by now that they're kind of my go-to when it comes to basics. The alpaca knit, which I'm wearing right now in this really lovely camel color, has just come up as one of my most worn items over and over again. And again, actually, I'm also wearing the new cut of the cheeky jean, the original, which has the elasticity to it, and they are so comfortable. I just really haven't wanted to take them off. We had a really wet spring, so it meant that I had a lot of opportunity to wear them, and I definitely made the most of it. As usual, I will have every single piece that I mention linked down in the description box below, so do go and check that out if anything catches your eye, along with my sizing. I forgot to mention that one of the other things that I really love about Everlane is just how timeless their designs are. You kind of know that anything that you're adding to your closet is going to be a piece that you can reach for year after year, as opposed to feeling a bit stale or tired after a couple of seasons. And they always have really fun colors. Generally, their new launches are reimaginations of styles that they've done in a previous year, or else they will bring it back in new colors, which is fab. Now you know the drill. I'm going to run through the 10 items, and then I will have a styling section of this video, which I'm going to do slightly differently. I'm actually going to have a voiceover so I can talk through each look, as well as imagery on screen of each component of the outfit, so you can see how it's all come together. This video definitely does have a bit more of a winter slant to it, so really great for my friends in the Northern Hemisphere. But if you're in the Southern Hemisphere like myself, then hopefully you will get some inspiration for the upcoming autumn winter, which I know will be upon us before we realize it. So I'm going to start with my first piece, which is a knitwear item. I have to say, I think this is one of my favorite new designs that they've released. It's called the Diamond Stitch Cloud Crew, and I have it in the light charcoal, which to me is actually more of a gray marl. It has a mid gray, and then it also has flecks of a lighter gray throughout it. And then you also have the additional texture from the diamond stitch too, which I think is really special. I sized up to a medium for a super slouchy fit. And I also have this one in the ivory as well, which is also gorgeous. And it comes in some really fun colors. My second knitwear pick, I wanted to introduce a little bit of color, and I've gone with the Air Slub Henley Mock Neck Sweater in the color Burnt Sugar, which is a really pretty rose pink with a bit of a desaturated hue to it. These sorts of sweaters are really on trend with the buttons up the front, or even if you have a zip one too, which I like. And again, this one has loads of texture to it because it has a slight open weave, and I don't know whether it's going to be completely visible on camera, but I do find that there is a little bit of variation in the color of the yarn too, which again adds more visual interest. So it goes from being this really nice rosy pink to having some subtle apricot tones. And again, this one I got in a size medium, but we don't think you need to size up particularly for this one, as it's already quite a boxy fit. In terms of how these two both feel quite similar. They're really soft on your hand, and despite having wool in them, they're not itchy on the skin at all. I can wear these without a long sleeve underneath. The final top that I included is a layering piece, and this is one that I always have on standby in the colder months. It is the Pima Rib Turtleneck, and this one I have in the extra small in the black. It's really, really stretchy, but it is just such a good underlayer. Actually, also one that looks great on its own too, which you will see when it comes to the styling portion of this video. And it comes in a few other colors too, if you don't just want black, but I feel like this is a good one to start with, especially if you are just building up your capsule wardrobe. I've had mine for many years too, and it's held up incredibly well. Then we get on to bottoms. So I actually picked two pairs of black pants. They're slightly different silhouettes, and I did this on purpose just because I love these pieces and I wanted to show you how you can actually style these two different trousers and still make your outfits look very different. But I had filmed a different version of this 10x10 before I settled on these items, and I included the blue Way High jean instead. You could also do the 90s cheeky in a white if you love your winter whites, because that pair of jeans would go really nicely with the knits that I've showed you already. But start with the jeans. So as mentioned, I've included the Way High jeans in the coal color, which are just one of my favorite pairs of jeans, and I think these are also a really nice summer jean too, because they are weighty, they're really high-waisted, and they look incredible with a fitted top. They do also have that distressed hemline as well, which makes them a bit more casual. I wear mine in the 25. I do find that the leg lengths do vary ever so slightly depending on the wash that you get, and I have done an entire denim guide for Everlane, which I'm gonna link up in the cards up here if you would like to go and watch it, because I do a lot of side-by-sides, which is really useful if you're not too sure which style you want to go for. So that's my first trouser or jean pick. Then the second bottom option that I went with is the Go Weave trousers. And again, these are a pair of pants that I've had for a really long time. I love these because they are so comfortable, yet they are perfect for a workwear environment. You can actually wear them both in a more formal setting or in a more casual setting, just depending on the styling. Yeah, the waistband makes them very comfortable, but then the very sleek fabric dresses them up. So these I have in the size 2, and I would say they fit run a size large, because I'm usually Australian size 8, so yeah, that translates to a US 4, so size down one in these ones for sure. They're a really nice length on me as well, and the leg opening around the ankle is wide enough to fit in a boot without being too tight, which is perfect. Then I want to move on to jackets. So I included a blazer, and you know, originally I had thought maybe I'll go with my black oversized wool blazer, but I thought, let's mix things up. Let's add in a bit of extra texture. We already have that gray knit. Let's go with my herringbone oversized wool blazer. So this one, it's got a really kind of textural hand feel to it, very much what you'd expect a wool blazer to feel like, but it isn't itchy because it does have that very nice lining. This here I have in the US 2, but I recommend sticking with your usual size. I have the black one in the US 4, and I actually think it's a really nice fit on me. Again, another item that has just been in my wardrobe for years and has held up incredibly well. I really don't think there's any visible signs of wear to this, and I've worn it a ton. So that is one of my outerwear pieces. And then the second one that I included is this quilted jacket. So this one is called the Renew Long Liner. So for context, here in Australia, at least in Sydney where I live, our winters are incredibly mild, so it doesn't generally get much colder than a high of sort of 15 degrees in the winter. So for me, a jacket like this would actually be reasonable. However, I do have one of my favorite coats, and I did check, and sadly they weren't recutting this for this autumn winter season, but they do have some other fantastic coats on the website. This one is the Rewool coat. If you get lucky, you might be able to find one on Depop, but it's just such incredible quality, a really lovely Italian wool, and this one's actually made using recycled wool. So if I weren't including a jacket that's current, I probably would go for that one, because it does just pair with absolutely everything, being such a timeless style, and it's much thicker and heavyweight. Alternatively, their re-down and just their down jackets are really snuggly and cozy if you live in a particularly cold climate. So I would just switch out this jacket for one of those. They do have this really nice blanket style with the wrap, which I have in the sort of light blue smoke color, which is beautiful. But I decided to go for this one. It's in the color Kalamata, which is this beautiful olive green, and I have it in the size small. I would say stay true to size. It does have a zipper which zips both ways too, which is really neat if you want to expose a bit more of your legs. So that is my other jacket choice. Then we've got shoes. So I've included two pairs of shoes in this capsule, the first being the Italian leather square toe Chelsea boot. I really like these because they're a classic design, but they do have that ever so slightly modern twist with the squared off detail at the toe. They're very, very comfortable. I have wide feet, and I sized up a full size in these. I usually wear a US 9.5 in Everlane shoes, and I have these in the 10.5, and they fit me really well. I think if you had a narrow foot, I would just go up a half size. But really, really beautiful quality, and they do add that nice little bit of shine to the outfit as well. Then I have also included a ballerina flat. These ones aren't from Everlane, but I think if you wanted something similar from the brand, their day gloves are great. I just wore my day gloves to the ground, so they're really not appropriate for me to be showing you on screen, but I wanted to do these ones. They also have a nice low block heel. And then the bag that I'm going to be featuring, which is my 10th item, is the studio bag, which I love. And this actually has been a really great bag to use both as a baby bag, an everyday bag. It's a really, really nice size, and it comes in a few different colors too. I did this a little bit differently because normally I wouldn't include so many accessories. So yeah, those are my 10 items. I am now going to get into the outfits. So I wanted to kick things off with a monochromatic look, and here proportion and balance is key. So the trousers have a wider fit to them, or the jeans should I say. So I've worn them with a fitted turtleneck top, and I've also exposed a little bit of my feet, though if it were especially cold, you could also wear some little tights or short socks with this look too. Then as a variation, I've thrown that gray sweater over my shoulders. I could also wear it with the outfit as a layered piece using the turtleneck to add that extra warmth really close to my body, but still being very thin and not adding any extra bulk. And this is definitely a really easy way to layer up without actually throwing on any outerwear. Then for the third variation on this look, you can see that I've opted for the herringbone dark gray blazer, which I really like because it smartens the look up a little bit. I still have on those pointed toe pumps, which I think make this a very nice look if you work in a casual environment, while adding in that slightly tailored element through the blazer. The next series of looks is kind of all centered around this pink knit, and you can see I've swapped out those jeans for the trousers, and I'm also wearing a boot here too, so no cold ankles. I have also layered that black turtleneck underneath for extra warmth, and that's especially what I love those Everlane Pima Cotton turtlenecks for. I think they are brilliant for layering. You could also add a blazer to the top of this too if you wanted a bit more of a smarter element. This reminds me a lot of Dead Florette and her styling. And then here you can see I've actually swapped out the pink knit and the turtleneck entirely for that gray knit, which I've worn half tucked in. I've also switched out the shoes for the ballerina pumps, and this is a look that I leaned on very heavily when I was working in publicity in the television industry. Okay, so you can see here I've done a little bit of layering, and for me the color palette was really what I loved about this outfit. The pink, the gray, the olive green, and the black. I just think it all looked very harmonious. But you can see the knit that I've got around my shoulders, it's essentially functioning like a scarf, and that's something that you could do with any of your knitwear pieces, especially if you want to add in a little bit of extra texture. Here I'm showing you that exact same look but without the knit. It just feels really kind of fresh with that beautiful olive liner jacket, and I really love the texture that that adds to the look. So not only do you have the texture from the knit, but you also have the texture from the jacket as well. And of course, if you wanted to, you could easily just wear the knit worn loose too for a little bit more of a casual vibe. Okay, next look, we are back to jeans, and I'm wearing that pink knit with it, and I really love the way that this looks tucked in. I think it is really sweet. I've exposed a little bit of skin here, and I've gone for the ballerina pumps because it has a bit more of a feminine slant to it, which is really down to the color of the actual knit itself, which has the best texture. You can really see it here. The next outfit is a bit of a variation on it. So I've actually switched out the little ballerina pumps for some black boots, and I've thrown on that olive toned liner jacket. I really, as I said, I love this color combination. I think it is really, really pretty. It's a really nice way to sort of mix colors while still going for a very minimal or neutral color palette. Back again with another all black outfit, very similar to the first look, but I'm wearing the tailored trousers here, and then I've also put on the boots. And this is the kind of look which I think is really great for exploring a city while still feeling a little bit smart at the same time, and you're able to put all of your essentials in that studio bag. Here I've layered the liner coat over the top so you can see how that looks, and here you can really get a sense of the functionality of the zipper, which zips up at both the top and the bottom, so you really get full range of motion when walking around. And I like the fact that the trim on the jacket is black, works very seamlessly when wearing an all black outfit like I have on underneath.
The next two outfits are centered around wearing this gray knit with my black waist-high jeans. I've worn them with the boots this time, which just does have a little bit more of a casual bent to it. And I decided to wear it untucked, which is definitely a silhouette that I am finding myself drawn to. The trick is to really add in a slimmer silhouette somewhere. For me, it's the fact that the boots are a little bit more fitted around the ankle. Here is a way to make it feel a little bit more tailored, just by throwing on that herringbone blazer for that more structured, clean, crisp lines. And again, this would be a way that you could potentially wear a look like this to the office if you worked in a casual environment.
So there you have it. That is my 10 by 10 with Evelyn for this month. I hope that you enjoyed this video, that you got some outfit ideas. I know that I am definitely feeling really inspired for the autumn winter season ahead, and I'm going to be banking some of these outfits for when it starts to cool down here in Sydney. As I said at the start of the video, every single piece that I mentioned will be linked down in the description box below if you would like to go and check anything out. But thank you so much for watching and for spending some of your day with me as always. I will see you next week with a brand new video. See you soon. Bye.